Yo tengo la enfermedad poliquística renal y hepática. Obviamente lo primero que se dañaron fueron los riñones. Por eso fue que necesité primero diálisis y luego trasplante. Cuando uno tiene el problema poliquístico, es muy común las infecciones repetitivas. O sea que yo ya arrastraba un historial de infecciones. Cuando ya me trasplantaron, reincidí en las infecciones y ya no estaban muy resistentes a las bacterias.
Polycystic disease is a genetic illness in which, in the patient's case, she has multiple cysts, which are basically fluid-filled sort of bubbles on both her kidneys and actually on her liver as well. And for the kidneys, over time, it led to kidney failure. And she had both of those kidneys removed, and she now has a transplanted kidney. The liver cysts, I think, are actually one of the sources of her infection. So she's had an issue with recurrent bacteremia, so meaning bloodstream infections that keep on coming back. It's always the same bug, and it's very difficult to treat. It's very drug resistant. So every time she has the bacteria in her blood, she requires IV antibiotics. Every time she finished the IV antibiotic, within 1 to 2 weeks, she was back in the hospital with fever and a bloodstream infection.
Sentía que ya me estaba yendo, entonces lo vi como una alternativa. Dije, no, no voy a perder nada si lo intento, al contrario, puedo ganar. Lo hice con toda la fe del mundo. Afortunadamente, al iniciar el tratamiento, no hubo ninguna reacción secundaria, como a veces se dan casos.
So with phage therapy, I was really interested to see if we could, one, find phages that would target her bacteria, and then also actually, once we treated her, to see if we could eradicate it. Phages are viruses that specifically infect bacteria and kill them, what we call lyses. And so phage therapy consists of finding phages that are specific for a patient's infecting organism, and lytic phages, meaning when they go in, the virus takes over the bacteria's replication system and starts making, many thousands of viruses within that bacteria. And then when it's full, it kind of bursts open and kills the bacteria. But then all those multiple sort of baby viruses that are formed go on to infect more bacteria. And so it's a self-replicating sort of way of treating, which makes it attractive. And so phage therapy, again, are viruses that we give to patients that specifically kill their bacterial infection. And these viruses do not infect human cells.
Estoy muy contenta de haber participado en un programa experimental de bacteriófagos y que pienso que estamos un paso al futuro de que los fagos, la terapia de fagos va a venir a suplir o va a venir a suplir a los antibióticos que no pueden acabar con las bacterias resistentes. Es una gran ayuda, un gran adelanto.